guess I'm still a nigga. I fuck where it ease my mind. Cause I be in my feelings. Every single person in my life tell me I'm the hero. But when it's up and then go down, it treat me like the villain. Guess I forgot to mention I'm just a nigga with a broken heart trying to find my way back home.
What's poppin' YouTube? It's your boy J-Mai Reese back at it again with another YouTube video. Today's YouTube video is going to be something slightly different. I think I've done one of these. And the last one that I did was a coming out story, okay? So today's video is going to be about my first relationship. One moment. Okay, y'all, I'm back. So, story time on my first ever boyfriend. All right. Yeah. That's all I gotta say. That's the only intro I have. Before we get into the video, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, press the notification bell to be notified every time that I put up a new video. And don't forget to tell a friend, 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 tell another 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 friend to come over here and join the J-Mob, period. And yeah, without further ado, let's get right into the B-Z. Hi.
Yep.
First, disclaimer, nothing against the person. Okay, I don't have a problem with any of my exes. This is just something that, some of my friends and some of my subscribers that have, followed me on my social medias, have DM'd and texted me on Twitter and all of that, that they suggested I should do a video on one of my exes. So, hey, Bella Wella, you gonna come say hey in my video? Come here. Come here. Say hey. Hey. All right, bye. But, so this is a video that they had said I should do. Most people know I don't want any drama out of this video. I have nothing to say, nothing necessarily bad to say about the person who I'm going to be talking about today. Me and this person have been through a lot of drama, a lot of back and forth, a lot of stuff. I love this person as a human being, a great person to know. Has helped me notice a lot, helped me grow as a person. Can you not cry about my father leaving? He's coming back. But it just did not work in a relationship, okay? That was my disclaimer, all right? No tea, no shade about the person, just telling the story from my perspective. And, you know, I still could possibly get stuff wrong because, you know, everything is from my perspective and he doesn't really have a say-so in how I feel. You get what I'm saying? So, that I just have to get that out of the way. Into the video. Okay. Woo! Now that I have that out of the way. The video. Okay. So, I'm going to try to make this as short and sweet as possible, but, you know, why not? You know, make it a little juicy. So, it was ninth grade. All right. Ninth grade, I had my first boyfriend. If y'all are loyal and y'all watched my coming out story, y'all should know that I came out in the ninth grade. But this was before I came out, okay? So, I was still, quote unquote, in the closet to my family. Or not to my family, but to my parents. But everyone else, I was basically out to. Everyone knew I was gay. I said I was bisexual. I feel like everyone says they're bisexual. But, girl, you gay. So, I said I was bisexual, all of this, all of that. So this is when this, what am I gonna say his name is? I wanna do it kind of close to the name. No, I'm not, totally different. Jeremiah, okay, his name is Jeremiah. So me and Jeremiah met through Instagram like a lot of gay people do today, especially around my age. I had messed around with a couple of boys. Not really anything serious. They were all DLs. This is my first real out boy. Everyone was DL, football player, basketball player, baseball player, or just not a player at all, but just DL. So never really messed with anyone at my school. He did not go to my school. He lived far away. Like far enough that there was a whole time difference. Okay. Well, my scalp a little dry. But anyway, move along. So yes, me and this guy met through Instagram. He followed me first. I do believe I possibly could have followed him first. I followed a lot of people. But from my understanding, he followed me first. And he kind of made the first move because he liked almost every picture on my page. When I say every picture, I mean every picture, almost everyone. And he had comments under a couple and all of that. Those pictures that he liked and commented under, most of them are now like deleted or archived. But it was really sweet that he did. Of course, it was still awkward because I was like, who just likes everyone's pictures? But I ended up doing the same thing because I looked at his page and I was like, oh, he got a cute. So I followed him back, liked a lot of his pictures. For about 2 to 3 weeks, we just went back and forth with commenting under each other's posts, you know, little sub stuff. Commenting under each other's posts, liking each other's pictures, reacting to each other's stories. I don't know, I think this was before Instagram had reactions, right? Yeah, I think so. So that's what happened, okay? And then I forgot who slid into whose DMs. This is freshman year, I'm now a junior, so I don't remember who slid into whose DMs first. I do believe that it was probably me. But it started off as just, you know, genuine conversation. Hey, where you from? I'm from here. I'm from Atlanta. Da-da-da-da. Blah, back and forth. The real cute flirtatious stuff, you know, saying I was cute. I was saying, oh, you're not too bad yourself. You know, all that. So we began talking. He had given me his iCloud, I do believe it, first. I didn't get his number first. I got his iCloud. Me, I gave him my number. So he had given me his number or his iCloud. We were texting, real lovey-dovey, real cute. We were texting about, texting on, you know, normal terms, you know, real flirtatious in the first phases of talking or whatever, for probably about a month to 2 month range, okay? And then it was just one of those, this is when I should have known something was wrong, okay? I know I'm all over the place, but this is when you should know that something is wrong. When y'all think that y'all just kind of understand what it is, kind of like an understood thing. Like, no one really formally asked each other out. What was it?
Bitch. The doll.
But neither one of us formally, like, asked each other out, okay? So it was just kind of like we went from calling each other our names and nicknames and stuff to like bae, baby, boo, poo, all that relationship stuff kind of. So it was understood to me at least, all of that. Still, we were dating for about 6 months. Then it became a little slightly toxic.
Whoa.
And that's when, not toxic. It wasn't toxic yet. It was just that you came out the honeymoon phase, let's say that, okay? So we came out the honeymoon phase and we never really argued about anything. It was more or less disagreement. And we only had like one or two. And it was, every time we would have multiple disagreements, it was about one of two things. And mainly because he had more of a following than I did. And still to this day, he has more of a following than I do. He's more known than me. He has a YouTube channel. I'm not going to say his YouTube channel unless while I'm editing, he tells me that I can put it in the description box if he wants his name to be known. But he had more of a knowing than I did. One moment. Hold on, y'all. Okay, yeah, I'm back. I'm sorry. My mama texted me about food, and you know I have to answer about food. What is going on? The trouble of having braces, y'all. Okay. But so, yeah, it was understood that we were dating. And if you know me as a person, you know, I am very discreet about my relationships. A lot of people do not know who I'm dating. A lot of people do not know if I'm taking nor single unless you hit me up in my DMs or you come for my nigga. Then I'll let you know. But I'm not one of those really lovey-dovey, oh, I'm going to post my man every time this. I'm going to post this. Ooh, I'm taking. Ooh, anniversary this. Ooh, 1 month this. Oh, did I? I'm not that person.
Okay.
And he wasn't that person either. But since he had more of a fan base, and he was more, at the time, he showed off more body. Still, he shows off more body than I do, which is his prerogative. Do your thing, boo. Do you. No see, no shade. For real, for real. I don't have a problem with it at all. Because he's single from what I understand. And he can do whatever he wants. And if he wasn't single and his boyfriend or situationship, entanglement, whatever. If they feel as if that is okay, then he can do whatever he wants. At the end of the day, he's not here to please me. Okay? Because he doesn't owe me anything. But he would make... My problem began because his followers were flirtatious. Extremely flirtatious because of what he posted. So he was very friendly. No, I don't do friendly stuff. That's something I can't do. I'm a friendly person in person, but through text with the flirtatious stuff, if I'm in a relationship, I'm in a relationship. It's very rare that I'm a flirtatious person, yes. So a lot of people do mistaken me being me and being a nice person as me flirting. But I let it be known once I can tell that you're kind of I'm misleading you. I'll let you know what it is, okay? And he wasn't that person, at least from what I saw. But we all had insecurities. And I have always been very insecure in my relationships. And after this relationship, I got even more insecure. So future relationships and everything like that just kind of went downhill for me. I've always been really insecure and insensitive and really worried now. But we live and we learn. So what happened was he would make little like questionnaire type questions on his stuff. Like, oh, if it was me plus you in a room equals what? This plus that, or what would you do if it was just me and you in a room and stuff like that? And he would respond to these people flirtatiously. And you're supposed to be in a quote unquote relationship with me. Now I see it and I call you out on it, but you know me, the first couple of times you're like, oh, I'm just, you know, being friendly, da 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 da, you know, ain't nothing gonna happen, blah, 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 that type of thing. So I'm letting it go. But then whenever I let you know how uncomfortable it makes me feel and how I really don't like it, as a boyfriend and as a person in a relationship, I personally feel if your spouse or whoever you're with, seriously, because if y'all just talking, your opinion is really irrelevant. But if y'all are supposed to be dating and your spouse truly says that something you're doing is really irritating them and really makes them uncomfortable, you should probably stop, okay? And we had crossed, by this time we were saying, I love you to each other, this is my first boyfriend, so I was head over heels. I don't know how many boyfriends this guy has had before me. He's told me about maybe one or two, but beyond that, I really do not know. So, not trying to say like he's out there or anything like that. That's not my business. I'm just being honest. I don't know how many boyfriends he's had before me or how many things, because from my understanding, well, I know that he's been out of the closet longer than I have. So he's had more boyfriends than me or talked to more guys. He was my first guy that I really talked to seriously. So, you know, I was very much sprung. So whenever that happened, it was like, oh, wow, really? And I broke up with him a couple of weeks later. Because I was like, oh, so you want to be, you acting like you single, you must want to be single. Do-do-do-do. I remember I did it in my algebra class freshman year. Never forget, I was sitting beside my friend Ramajay. I was like, Jeremy, so you must want to be single, da-da-da-da-da. Oh, blah, 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 you know what? So be single. Boom, broke up right then. And I thought I was a shit. I was hurt, but I thought I was a shit. I walked around that, when that bell rung, couldn't tell me shit. Fought that nigga. Bump him. I don't want him no more. I'm over him. Girl, I was so hurt. I was butt booty hurt.
I mean.
Butt booty hurt. And we didn't talk for about 2 weeks. And then we got back. We started talking again. And this is when I had taken it upon myself to think that we were talking again. When in his eyes, it was very much just entertaining. He was just entertaining me. I was just entertainment. I was the break. I was, you know, that's who I was. And apparently during this time, he had been talking to a lot of other people, but mind you, he was falling asleep on the phone with me sometimes. He was texting my phone every day. Good morning, good night, what you doing? Blah, 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 blah. Giving me all the attention that the little old boy who just came out wanted and loved. Girl, the girl loved it. Miss Thing wanted all of that, and he gave him everything he wanted. So yeah, but then fast forward, we basically stopped talking again. He apologized, and you know, he was real smooth with it. Baby boy, you're smooth. I'll give you your props. I need to learn from you. Okay? Like, I fucked with it. Like, now I really appreciate him. Because the way that he did it, the way he apologized, and to this day, personally, I don't know if his apology, my ears are huge, they just poke out. To this day, I really don't know if his apologies were sincere. I believe that they were coming from a place of sincerity, if that's even a word. But after you get hurt a couple of times, you start to not believe the person. So that's where I'm coming from in that situation. Now, I mean, if he texts me, we can have a conversation. I'm still cool with his family, or the family that I at least know. His brother has the same name as me. I love Joshua. Like, Joshua, if I ever see that man, I'll probably cry. He's so funny. His sister, I love that girl. That's my girl. I love her. But me and him aren't really in communication, just because I guess that's what time has done to our, like, friendship, relationship type thing. You know how, like, you have a relationship that's not a relationship, our friendship, okay? So our friendship, yeah. So our friendship and our connection has kind of disappeared over the time, which I completely respect. I'm not gonna say why, but I respect why it happened. I respect how he feels about situations and everything that we've been through. I mean, that really can make you not like a person, not really want to mess with them. So I completely respect him as a person. But so one day, back to the story, y'all. I just keep getting sidetracked and going deep into stuff. We had started talking again, or in my opinion, talking again, and he wasn't really claiming me, which I found out, but he would go live. He doesn't really go live that much anymore. He pops up every now and again, and, you know, I'll jump in. He'll hop into my live every now and again, and, you know, I'll say, hey, how you doing? Da, 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 da. We have each other's numbers. We don't talk that much. We have just Instagram, social medias, all that. So he would never go live with me. And just like I said, he has, like, a really good, I'm sorry, I was looking at Bella, but he has a really good following, like a fan, like almost like a tiny fan base. He's not like popular, but he has like 8-9K on Instagram, and he's known. He has like over 300-400 subscribers on YouTube. But he's just really cool people. He knew a lot of people. A lot of people liked him, thought he was attractive, as they should. So people would claim him that he was quote unquote flirting with. So one boy who I'm now friends with had popped in on his live and called him bae. I'm in the comments. Like, I'm watching the live in the comments, like, bae, da 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 da. So I do my little investigation stuff, period. I text the boy, oh, so how do you know? Did I say Jeremy? How do you know Jeremy? Oh yeah, you cool people. Me and the guy get each other's numbers, we FaceTime, we talking, vibing, da 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 da, yada yada yada. And then I found out that the reason why he knows Jeremy is because Jeremy has been flirting with him the same way he's been flirting with me. You know, when I say flirting, or like flirt, being flirtatious, is you know, when you post something on your story and a person that likes you, person that's trying to talk to you, be like, oh, why you got that on? They'll be showing people what's mine, da 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 da, all that stuff. So that he was doing that to him as he was doing to me. Like, oh, why you taking a picture like that? Why you wearing that at school? Did my voice just shake? Bitch, what the? But why you wearing that at school? Da 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 da, all that. All that jazz. So, but mind you, he was telling me, I had nothing to worry about. Huh, little did he know I knew. So, he found out that I knew. Stopped talking. He basically, it was just bad. Like, I was so sprung on this guy that day that we, like, he broke up with me or stopped talking to me. I felt sick. I legit stayed in bed the entire day. I have never really sapped over anybody. But I sapped over him that day, them couple of days. Sure, did. Had me in my near, far, wherever you are. I should have bust the windows after I cry, cause forever, does it? I was all of that, baby. All of that. Tears flowing, depression in progress, baby. I was over. Done for. Making sad Instagram videos and, oh, you know when you make a video, you be like,
and I saw the real you. They got the boo. They got a dash boo.
I was on it. Baby was sprung. Baby was hurt. Baby was over it. So after that, he disappeared for a couple of weeks. Like almost maybe a couple of months. About two, three months. He'll make a little appearance here and there. We'll pop up on each other's stories, watching each other's stories, stuff like that. Like we would watch each other's stories still. And all of that. So fast forward, y'all, this is gonna be like a 28, 30 minute video. Just gonna say. We had jumped forward. Braces. Oh my God. Jump forward. I had got an invite. Me and him were talking. Not talking. Now we're like, well, we were, once again, me being stupid, I thought we was talking, okay? Apparently, he was just entertaining me. We were just friends. That started. Because we're two flirtatious people. Learn the difference, people. Don't be like me. Please. Please. Don't be like me. So, we had, he invited me to Bigo. A situation happened and we fell out again. Made the long story short. But at the very moment, me and him don't talk that much. We don't have a problem with each other, at least not on my part. From what he's shown me, we don't have a problem with each other. We've had small conversations. I think we talked like maybe 2 weeks ago. It was small, short, sweet, not too long. But yeah. So that was my first boyfriend. I was sprung, hurt, heartbroken. That's my first heartbreak, my first boyfriend, first real guy relationship, all in one. Okay, y'all, thank you. And like I said, I don't mean any shade through this video. Me and the guy don't have a problem with each other. I'm cordial, he's cordial. When we see each other, we see each other. I love his sister and his family. They're all really cool. Yeah, that's about all I have to say about that. If something does come off messy, just know I didn't mean it to be messy. But yeah. So, that's my first boyfriend. Comment below if y'all like this. Don't forget to press the thumbs up, to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Press the notification bell to be notified every time I upload a new video. Period, 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 period. And follow me on all my social media platforms. Instagram is _J.Myrees. Twitter is @JMyrees. Snapchat is Joshua Bullock. TikTok is in the description box below, but it's _J.Myrees. All this other stuff. All right, everything will be in the description box. Facebook will be in the description box. Everything will be in the description box. And my link to my coming out story will be in the description box. Okay? Period. So if you haven't watched that, go watch that. So that's some love. And my most recent that I just posted 2 days ago. Well, probably 2 to 3 days because I don't know when I'm going to upload this. But yeah. So without further ado, don't forget to tell a friend, 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 tell your cousin, tell your auntie, tell Autumn, Bebe, Kiki, Keisha, Spuggle, Keisha, Autumn, by the pure, to mess with your boy on this side of YouTube. Okay? And without further ado,
peace.